This is Colin O'Keefe here for LXBN TV. 2014 has been a big year for trade secret legislation, and that continues with a bill recently put forth in the House that would create a federal civil cause of action for trade secrets theft. Joining me now to explain this most recent piece of legislation and its potential impact is Attorney Robert Milligan. He is co-chair of Seyfarth Shaw's Trade Secrets Computer Fraud and Non-Competes Practice Group and editor of the firm's blog, Trading Secrets. Robert, first off, what are the basics of this most recent piece of legislation put forth by the House, and how does this compare to what recently came out of the Senate earlier this year?
Good morning, Colin. Thanks. Yeah, with respect to this new bill that's coming from the House, it's very similar to the bill that was proposed back in April in the Senate. There are some key differences. Primarily, the proposed legislation tightens up the ex parte seizure order language that was contained in the previous bills and essentially makes it more clear as far as when it's appropriate for the court to issue an order seizing the alleged misappropriated trade secret, and puts in place precautions such as a bond and protection against publicity for the trade secret misappropriator. So it kind of tightens the language that wasn't previously in the bill that was introduced in the Senate.
I see. And then second, what's the big picture here? We've seen a lot of support for bills like this. You know, of course, we've seen the bill come out of the Senate earlier this year, and this one here in the House, like the one in the Senate, has bipartisan support. So what is the likelihood that something like this ultimately comes to fruition?
I think we're cautiously optimistic. We saw the Congress last year make some progress on trade secret legislation and tightening the penalties for violations of the Economic Espionage Act. I think the things that are going for this particular set of legislation is that it does, as you mentioned, have bipartisan support. So bipartisan support in both the House and the Senate. And I think, you know, George Holding and Jared Nadler, who put forth the House bill, the Trade Secrets Protection Act bill, are pretty high ranking in the House, and it's also bipartisan. And then on the Senate side, you have Orrin Hatch, who's high ranking, as well as Christopher Coons, again, bipartisan support for the bill. I think ultimately the differences in the reconciled, and it'll be just a matter if they can get the votes in the House and the Senate to get it through. So I think it stands a chance of getting through based upon the past history. And as you mentioned, a number of companies have come out in support of creating a civil cause of action for trade secret misappropriation. Some of those companies being Microsoft, GE, DuPont, and there was recently some testimony on the Hill as far as why we need a civil cause of action for trade secret theft, and the Boeing Corp came out in favor of it as well. So at least the business community and some members of Congress look to be looking to create a civil cause of action for trade secret misappropriation.
That's interesting to hear. The big issue nowadays, of course, is whether or not Congress can actually get something completely done, whether or not they can actually work together and ultimately pass an impactful piece of legislation. Once again, that was Robert Milligan. He is editor of Seyfarth Shaw's Trading Secrets, and you can find that blog at tradesecretslaw.com. Thank you for joining me today, Robert.
Thanks, Colin.